Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum students. Today I am going to give you the complete explanation related to the exercise of the unit Sultan Ahmed Masjid. In my previous lectures, I have given you the complete grammatical details of the concepts which are coming in the first lecture. And in the second lecture, I have given you the grammatical explanation of all the passages one by one, and I have given you the detail of all the important words as we repeat this grid in each and every lecture. Now I am coming towards this lecture. In this lecture, before going to start the exercise, I am going to tell you one important thing, that what type of things we have learned from the previous lectures, because all these objectives will help us to solve this exercise fully. Now I am coming towards the first objective. We have learned to recognize various positions of adverbs. I have given you a precise chart in which I have discussed all the positions of adverbs and their use in the sentences. We have learned the use of present perfect continuous tense, and when we have discussed present perfect continuous tense, we have learned the use of for and since. And we have learned the essentials of descriptive writing, degree of comparison, and the writing skills. We will go and focus upon all these objectives in this lesson with relation to the exercise. First of all, in the exercise, they have given you the glossary. The glossary is over here in front of you, but I have given you all the important words from all the passages in my previous lecture. And from this lecture, you can prepare all important words, but these specific words are over here in front of you with their complete description. Now I am coming towards oral activity. As I have told you before, that oral activity is not less important. You have to focus upon this oral activity, because sometimes question will come from this activity also in the paper. The oral activity in the solve form is over here, and I am going to explain this activity in front of you. The first question which you have to discuss in group discussion is, what makes the Blue Mosque famous in the world? The blue tiles that embellish its interior make it famous all over the world. Which feature the mosque does appeal to you the most, and why? The design of the Blue Mosque appeals me the most because it is one of the wonders of Muslim architecture all over the world. Next is, prepare a class presentation on role of mosque in Islamic culture. Okay students, you have to prepare this role of mosque in Islamic culture by taking up the help from my previous lecture, in which I have explained the architecture and the love of Muslim rulers for the mosques and their importance in their reign towards Islam. Now I am coming towards the comprehension. Yes, that is, we are going to discuss the question answers from this lesson. The question answers are over here on the screen, and I am going to explain them. The first question is, why Sultan Ahmed is also known as a Blue Mosque? Sultan Ahmed Masjid is also known as the Blue Mosque because of the blue tiles that embellish its interior. Second question, who was appointed as the architect of the mosque? The royal architect Siddhar Mehmed Agha, appointed as an architect of the mosque by the Sultan and also in charge of the project. Why was a heavy iron chain hung at the entrance of the court? A heavy iron chain hangs in the upper part of the court entrance on the western side. This side was meant for the Sultan alone. The chain was put there so that the Sultan had to lower his head every time he entered the court. It was the symbolic gesture to ensure the humility of the ruler in the face of the divine. How does the interior of the mosque look? The interior of the mosque is embellished with blue tiles, which gives its interior a creative look. Why do you think madrasa and hospice was a part of the mosque? Madrasa was the student, was for the students who came to acquire Islamic knowledge and religious education, and the hospice was for the needy and the insolvent people. Who constructed Mosque Sophia? Hagia Sophia mosque was constructed by an Ottoman caliph. Okay students, after discussing the comprehension, now we will come towards the activities related the vocabulary. And the activities related the vocabulary, the first activity, that is part A of vocabulary, is you have to tell the synonyms of the given words. I have given you all the synonyms of all the important words in my previous lecture, but these synonyms are also present in front of you. You can take help from here to learn only the specific synonyms of these specific words. The next activity B related to vocabulary is you have to choose the correct antonym for the given words, and I am going to solve this activity in front of you. The activity is over here on the screen. The first sentence is, the Sultan Ahmed Masjid is one of the most impressive monuments in the world. Impressive, the antonym for impressive is unimpressive. Situated in Istanbul, the largest city in Turkey. The largest, the antonym for largest is smallest. A heavy iron chain is hung at the upper part of the court entrance at the western side. Heavy, light. The upper level of the interior is adorned with blue paint. Upper, lower. The floors are covered with carpets. Covered, exposed. Students, these are the antonyms of the specific words that are given related to the activity of vocabulary. But I have given you all the antonyms of all the important words from the complete chapter in my previous lecture, and you have to prepare these antonyms, because in paper it is not compulsory that the antonyms will come from the exercise. They can ask any word, they can ask the antonym of any word from the chapter also. So you can prepare and you can take help from my previous lecture. Now I am coming towards the next activity related to the vocabulary, and in this activity you have to make sentences from the specified words that are given in the exercise. But I have given you the complete important words and their with their sentences in my previous lecture, and this specific activity is over here on the screen in front of you. You can take help from this activity and you can prepare the sentences one by one. The first word is impressive. The major has a very impressive personality. Dexterously. The engineer built massive very dexterously. Spacious. Ahmed lives in a spacious house. Humility. Hazrat Asma Raziallah Anha was the example of humility. Flamboyant. The flamboyant design of tiles makes this mosque beautiful. In the next activity D related to the vocabulary, they have given you some abbreviations and you have to tell the complete form of words for these abbreviations. These abbreviations are over here on the screen with their solved form, and I am going to explain in front of you. The first abbreviation is USA. It stands for United States of America. UK, United Kingdom. UAE, United Arab Emirates. ICU, Intensive Care Unit. MBBS, Bachelors of Medicines and Bachelors of Surgery. PhD, Doctor of Philosophy. MPhil, Masters in Philosophy. PAF, Pakistan Air Force. NADRA, NADRA, National Database and Registration Authority. UN, United Nations. ISSB, Interior Services Selection Board. WABDA, Water and Power Development Authority. PTB, Pakistan Tobacco Board. Pakistan Technology Board. Punjab Text Board. MNA, Member of National Assembly. MPA, Member of Provincial Assembly. IMF, International Monetary Fund. WHO, World Health Organization. WTO, World Trade Organization, UNESCO, UNE, SCO, United Nations Education, Scientific and Cultural Organization, UNICEF, 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 United Nations International Children Emergency Fund Organization. Okay students, after completing all the activities related to the vocabulary, now there is a turn towards the activities related to the grammar. And as you know that in grammar we have discussed these concepts, we have discussed the position of adverbs, present perfect continuous tense, and in present perfect continuous tense we have learned the use of for and since, and we have learned the degree of comparison. So we will discuss in these activities all these grammatical concepts, and for complete explanation you can go towards my previous lecture, that is lecture number 1 from this chapter. Yes, part 1 of this chapter you have to consult. And now I am coming towards the first activity related to the grammar. You have to place the adverbs at an appropriate position. She comes here often. She often comes here. He goes to Lahore sometimes. He sometimes goes to Lahore. The teacher was late hardly ever. The teacher was hardly ever late. We are tired by the end of the day. We are usually tired by the end of the day. I have posted a letter to them. I have just posted a letter to them. He did his work. He did his work carefully. Yes students, after placing the adverbs at their correct position, the next activity related to the grammar is you have to give the degree of comparison. Yes, they have given you the positive degree and you have to write out the comparative degree and the superlative degree for the given words, and I am going to tell you the comparative and superlative degrees for the given words. The solution is over here on the screen, and I am going to explain all these words in front of you. The positive degree is kept much, comparative degree is kept more, and the superlative degree is kept most. Sang beautifully. Sang beautifully is the comparative degree, and sang beautifully is the superlative degree. Slept little. Slept less is the comparative degree, and slept least is the superlative degree. Looked good. Looked better is the comparative degree, and looked best is the superlative degree. Arrived early. Arrived earlier is the comparative degree, and arrives earliest is the superlative degree. Okay students, the next activity is also related to the similar concept, that is the degree of comparison. Yes, they have given you some sentences and they have asked you to put the degree of comparison with each and every sentence appropriately. Now I am going to give you the solution of all these sentences over here on the screen. The first sentence is, they came early this morning. I came earlier and he came earliest of all. This is the example. He kept much patience. This is the first sentence. He kept more patience. He kept most patience of all. She drew a painting beautifully. She drew a painting more beautifully than her friend. She drew a painting most beautifully of all. The third sentence is, she slept little. She slept less. She slept least of all. He looked good. He looked better than before. He looked the best of all. Shehzad arrived early. Shehzad arrived earlier. Shehzad arrived earliest of all. Here one thing is very important students, that from these sentences one thing is very clear, then you, when you are going to towards the use of comparative degree, this degree is used when you are going to compare two things with each other, and when you are going to use the superlative degree, then it means that it is the super thing from all. If this thing is not comparable towards to anyone, so this is the main use of these degrees when you are going to use these degrees in a sentence. Now I am coming towards the next activity. The next activity, short form is over here on the screen. Put for or since in the blanks. I have been studying for 3 hours. I have been watching TV since 7 p.m. Tara has not been feeling well for 2 weeks. Tara has not been visiting us since March. He has been playing football for a long time. He has been living in Bangkok since he left school. The next activity is related to present perfect continuous tense. I have discussed this tense completely and comprehendingly in my first lecture related to this chapter. Here I am going to give you the solution of this activity. These sentences are over here on the screen. You can make any other type of sentences related to this tense, as I have given you the complete concept of this tense. So this is not compulsory that you have to make only these sentences and you have to learn them only. You can make it on by own. And there is no need to learn this activity. The need is to confirm and the need is to consider upon the making and the use of this sentences, this tense, which I have told you in the previous lectures very in a detailed manner. Okay students, the next activity is related to the writing skills. You have to write down about Sultan Ahmed Masjid especially, and you have to write about the Badshahi Mosque. I have given you complete detail about Sultan Ahmed Masjid from this complete chapter. You can take help from all of my 3 lectures to prepare this activity. You can add something and you can delete something in this essay which is present in front of you over the screen. But you can learn, and if you are unable to add or delete something in this, then you can learn this specific essay also. Now I am coming towards the words you have to write out about 170 to 200 words about Badshahi Mosque. This is also an essay that you can prepare for your paper also. This essay is also available in front of you over here on the screen. You can take help from this essay and you can prepare it comprehendedly from here. Now students, this is the complete detailed lecture about the exercise of this unit, and inshallah ta'ala I will meet you as soon as possible with my next lecture, in which we will discuss the next chapter inshallah ta'ala. Till then you have to wait for me. Allah Hafiz.